Good day, students. This is science class for grade 7, chapter 1, Nutrition in Plants. In the last video session, we learned in detail the autotrophic mode of nutrition and the process of photosynthesis. In today's video session, let us understand the synthesis of food by plants other than carbohydrates. Now, what is this carbohydrates? Let us understand this term first. The process of photosynthesis is represented as, we have already learned in the last video session, that is the carbon dioxide from the air is combined with water, that is from the soil, in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll to form glucose and oxygen. Now, this glucose is nothing but carbohydrate. So, glucose is a carbohydrate. Carbohydrates are made up of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Carbohydrates are made up of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Now, these are used to synthesize or to produce other components of food such as proteins and fats. Proteins and fats. Here, the proteins, they contain nitrogen. And from where do plants obtain this nitrogen? This nitrogen is obtained by the plants from the soil. The nitrogen present in the air. The nitrogen is present in the air. And there are some bacteria present in the soil that convert this nitrogen in the air, they convert the nitrogen in the air into the form that can be easily absorbed and used by the plants. So such bacteria are called the nitrogen fixing bacteria. For example, the bacteria Rhizobium is a nitrogen fixing bacteria. So this way the plants produce the other components of food other than the carbohydrates. Is this clear, students? Okay, now next let us move to the next mode of nutrition, that is the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Heterotrophic mode of nutrition is a mode of nutrition in which organisms do not prepare their own food. Organisms do not prepare their own food. They directly or indirectly depend on plants for the food. The organisms exhibiting this type of nutrition are called the heterotrophs. So all animals, including humans and the non-green plants, are the heterotrophs. Now, non-green plants, they do not have chlorophyll, and thus they cannot carry out the process of photosynthesis. In some cases, the plant may have chlorophyll and can photosynthesize, yet it is dependent on other organisms to derive the nutrition or to obtain the nutrition. So now let us discuss few examples of heterotrophic nutrition in plants. Heterotrophic nutrition in plants. So first let us understand what are parasitic plants. So in this type of nutrition, a plant lives on another living plant. A plant lives on another living plant and obtains its nutrition from the living plant. So the plant that derives nutrition is called as the parasite. That is, the plants which obtain nourishment from the bodies of the other plants and animals are called parasites. And then the plant or animal through which the parasite obtains the nutrients is called the host. Okay, that is the plant from which the parasite derives its nutrition is called the host. Now, examples of parasitic plants are the cuscuta. The plant cuscuta, or it is called the dodder, also we call it as amarbel. Amarbel. So this plant, cuscuta, or the dodder, or amarbel, it climbs on the host plant to absorb the minerals. Okay, so it will absorb the nutrients from the host plant by its special structures. Okay, so cuscuta is a pale yellow. It is a pale yellow twining plant. Okay, twining plant we often see on the trees, on the tree tops. So it absorbs its nutrients from the tree by using the special roots. Is it clear, students? And we have one more parasitic plant called as Rafflesia. And this parasitic plant is found in the forest of Malaysia. And this plant has the biggest and the heaviest flower. And this flower, the Rafflesia flower, weighs around 10 kg. So it is the heaviest flower. And these both, that is cuscuta and Rafflesia, are the total parasites. They live on another living plant and obtain their nutrition. Is this clear, students? Yes. So next, let us learn about the, okay, so I told you these both are the total parasites. So they completely depend on the other living plant. And there is one more called as the partial parasite. So the example of a plant which is partially parasite is the mistletoe. Okay, this is a partial parasitic plant. So here what happens is this plant prepares its own food, but it depends on the other plants for the need of water and minerals. Okay, so this is a partial parasite which prepares its own food, but it depends on other plants for the water and minerals. Is this clear, students? Okay. In the next video session, let us learn in detail about the insectivorous plants, saprophytic plants, and the symbiotic nutrition. That is the symbiotic plants. Thank you, students.